Hey guys and girls, and welcome to day 10 of the London 2012 Olympic Games. Today we have four events: the men's 100 meter sprint, the men's hammer throw, men's badminton, and men's shooting. So it's a pretty much all male event today. So let's get started with our first event: the men's 100 meters. Right, let's see. What kind of guy should we use for this one? I'm kind of tempted to pick Sonic, but we kind of picked him yesterday for the long jumps, so I want to choose somebody different. Somebody who can run as fast as Sonic, but... yeah. Someone who could run as fast as Sonic, and you know what, guys? I think I know just who we could choose. Dr. Robotnik! Because if you guys have ever played Sonic 2, you know. You know. Alright guys, the 100 meter sprint in the Olympic Stadium. We are live from the Olympic Stadium, broadcasting from Stratford. It still baffles me why the whole Olympic Park is in Stratford. Stratford, I mean, really, Stratford. I can't get over that at all. Okay, I understand, you know, Stratford's one of the areas in the East End of London that could really do with like financial injection and what have you too. Oh fuck, I nearly false started. But you know, is the Olympics really gonna do it for Stratford? Oh, he came second place! What was Robotnik doing? What was his special dash? He twirls. Really? He twirls. Obvious result! Well, not really, but... the Dr. Robotnik gets the silver. Unlike Mohamed Farah last night, who won the gold medal after running 10,000 metres. That is one hell of an accomplishment. I mean, Great Britain did very well yesterday. We won six medals. That was absolutely incredible, but... you know, that one medal there that Mo Farah won... that was an incredible medal. Very well deserved, I think, that guy. It was incredible, because I was watching Tim Hobnob's stream last night, and I was also watching several of the events in the Olympics as well, one of them being the football, which I'll get to in just a moment. The other one was basketball, which I'll also get to in just a moment. And the other one, obviously, was athletics. You know, I was chopping and changing between those three events. And wow, I saw the other 10,000 meter start, and before I go anything further, what we've got to do now? Hammer throw. 10,000 meter start, and I thought, okay, yep, this is going to be like a long race, because, you know, 10,000 meters, it's quite long, it's about a half an hour race, give or take. So I was sort of like dipping in and out of the race, looking at the football and the basketball, and I was like, when it came to the end of the, at the end of the race, it came towards the end of the race, and... I think what we'll do, we'll have Bowser for the hammer throw, because why not? See, number tries three. So when it was towards the end of the race, I saw like Mo Farah, he was in second, and I thought, well, he's probably going to dip into about third or fourth. I did not expect him to finish first, because I just about caught the last 100 metres, and I saw that he was in front, and I thought, fucking hell, he's going to win it! And he took the gold. Very fucking well deserved, if you ask me. Alright, here we go. Hammer throw. Oh yeah, of course. You gotta get that timing perfect. Come on, Bowser, will it? Will it? Oh, have we broken the Olympic record? Come on, SBO, give us some good news. Oh, just shy. Fucking hell, you don't fuck with Bowser. Right. We're first, so we pretty much don't. We can take our foot off the pedal now. So what else was there? Oh yes, that's right. I was watching the basketball. My God, Great Britain got spanked by the Australians last night. Hang on a minute, guys. Ooh. Yeah, Great Britain got spanked by the Australians last night. What was the final score? It was 75-106. And we still haven't beaten the Olympic record. Fuck. We'll try to do it on our last one. So Australia won 106 points, which obviously is a very good performance because that's the only game I've seen so far in Olympic basketball where the score has actually gone over 100. That was one hell of a fucking score though. Ooh, great. Nah, it's not going to go anywhere. That's about 70 metres. It was a shame because Great Britain, they actually started off quite well against the Aussies, you know. Yeah, they were about a good, 15 points ahead of them throughout at least the first couple of quarters anyway, give or take. And we won. Great Bowser. I said Bowser, not Browser. Well, those two events really do take it out of you. Well, 100 metres doesn't really, but the hammer throw, wow. You really have got it, much like the Beijing Games, you've really got to fucking give it some. Goes Luigi, better than Waluigi. However, the King of the Koopas has won the gold. To be fair, it was pretty much academic, really. I mean, look at the fucking size of him. He dwarfs Luigi, and Luigi is no short fucker. Right, let's select our next event. Oh, goody gumdrops, we've got fucking men's badminton. Oh well, at least it's only the last time we have to play it, so. Who shall we have? You know something, I haven't played as Yoshi yet, I don't think. At least not like as player one. I think I've had him either as part of a team or within the dream events, so. And who shall we partner him with? It's a tricky one. I think we should go Team Green. Bring it on. Yoshi and Vector, baby. Hang on a minute. Haven't I already chosen Vector for the didn't I choose Vector for the mixed doubles? Or was that the computer? Oh no, I think it was actually against the computer that Vector was, if I remember rightly, because I lost against him. Because I remember a comment made a couple of days ago about about losing against Vector, and Vector had a word with Espio and what have you, because I remember that comment, that made me giggle. The London Sports Arena. Metal Sonic versus Bowser. As if the hammer throw wasn't enough for Bowser, he's going to try and go for badminton gold. And knowing this computer's bullshit rules, they're probably likely to get it, but. Team Yoshi! Yoshi could just suck in the shuttlecock and spit it back out. You know. If Kirby was in this game, he'd suck in the shuttlecock and become the shuttlecock. Alright, here we go, guys. More bullshit ready. What the fuck? Can we get a replay of that? Oh fuck, okay, that was actually my fault. I did swing too early. As much as I'd love to have a go at the game for that, I can't. Oh, here we go. Nice one, Vector! I was just literally just this minute ago thinking about Vector, and I obviously thought, you know, he's in, Team Chaotix and whatnot, and thinking of Chaotix, you know, it made me think, you know, why haven't Sega and Sonic Team brought back Mighty the Armadillo? He was part of Chaotix. Bowser, you missed. Now you know how it feels, you bastard. Yeah, I'm sure they could use Mighty in something. They could have brought Mighty back in Sonic Generations. You know, instead of putting them on a fucking wanted poster, or missing poster, excuse me. Oh, and he just. Nuh-uh. No way, Metal Sonic.
Nahee!
Oh, you cheeky bastard! You didn't get that one, though. What's the deal? What's going on with that? Oh, well. Match point! Oh, shit. No, oh, fuck off. Can I get a replay of that, please? Why is it not showing replays? That's horse manure. Oh, here we go. Nice! Very nice. Team Green, go through to the final. Bowser was like,
Wreckage in the wrong arm! God damn it!
You win. I can't actually remember what Bowser sounds like, but that during that one time he had actual proper voice acting. Ah, yeah, ah, yeah. Who do we square off against? We go against Team Donkey Kong in lane 4. It's a shame it's not called Team Shadow, because that sounds better. Team Yoshi. So I was watching the football last night, guys, and oh my god, what a game that was. That was an absolutely outstanding game. It lasted the full 90 minutes, then the additional time, then both sets of extra time, and then it went straight into penalty shootouts. Now, those of us living in the United Kingdom know all too well what England are like during penalty shootouts. Basically, they're shit. England just are no good at penalty shootouts. And I realised that last night was Great Britain doing it, but you've got English players in your team anyway, so at some point or another, something's going to happen. And oh my god, something did happen. Everything was going well, you know. Both teams had scored Both teams had scored 4 goals each, which was good. Even Ryan Giggs managed to get a penalty in as well, which was awesome. I couldn't even tell if that was going towards me or not. Well, obviously it was going towards me, but I couldn't tell if I was able to hit it or not. And that was quite quick. Okay, here we go. Here's a replay. I want to check it out. Okay, fair enough. It's hard to bat them back anyway, so can't really call bullshit on that. But yeah, it was what? 4 all on penalties, and then I can't remember the fella's name. But he steps up, he goes to take his penalty, he's halfway to the ball, and he stops briefly, and then carries on. And I looked, and I watched, and I thought to myself, you fucking idiot! And wait, okay, I should set the record straight now. I don't care for football, and it doesn't bother me in the slightest who wins what or anything. But last night, you know, obviously I'm back in, you know, Great Britain in pretty much most of the Olympics anyway, and I just saw that penalty, and I just couldn't believe it. He fucking bottled it! And I'm causing miss shots because I'm waving my hands around as well as I'm talking about the penalties. You think we should just throw this game? You know, much like what the Chinese did with badminton the other day. Or was it the Chinese, actually? I can't remember. I know, if I remember right, there was some sort of Asian team. But I remember the controversy. I only read briefly into the controversy surrounding the badminton. No points at all. You lose. Never mind, Yosh. We got a silver medal, that's good. Yeah, silver's better than bronze.
Silver medal, Team Yoshi.
Nice one, Team Yoshi. Alright guys, it's time for our final event of the day. We've got shooting! Men's shooting!
Shooting! One player!
Right. Haven't we already had men's shooting, actually, thinking about it? How come we got men's shooting again? Is there another actual shooting medal? Today, at some point, or what? That's really odd. Huh. It's probably a different distance for their shooting, so I know that you've got several different distances, so Yeah, not a problem. Well, it's tempting to choose Shadow, because we all know he's familiar with a gun, but we're going to go for somebody a little bit different. And you know who I'm going to pick? The person you'd least expect to handle a gun. Probably. Tails!
I can do it!
I fucking hope so, Tails. Although, in fairness, you know, what the Olympic Stadium... The Royal Artillery Barracks, sorry. Well, fuck it, you know. What with the bulk of the Olympics being held in the East End, you could practically get anybody from there to fucking participate in a shooting event. Right.
Tails! I can do it!
That's the second time you said that, Tails. How about that? Alright, guys. Let's see if Tails is any good with a gun. We know he's good at flying a plane, unless you watch Sonic Adventure 1. Oh fuck, I haven't got my fucking pistol attachment. Oh, that wasn't too bad, but I'm gonna get my pistol attachment now. There it is. Right, that means I've got to take my bloody wrist strap off. Sorry guys, I'll be with you in just a second, but whilst I put it in, might as well talk about the cycling. Oh my god, the cycling yesterday, that was pretty fantastic. I mean, I watched briefly I can't remember what the fucking type of event it's called, the Omnium. And, you know, to be fair, Ed Clancy was doing pretty well during the Omnium. I don't know if it's happening now or if it's happened already, so I don't quite know how far he's got during that. But I tell you what, the...
Round two, three.
But team... Hang on a minute, guys.
Three,
there we go. But I tell you what, Great Britain's performance during like the team pursuit, it was just like, it was fucking unbelievable. It was amazing. And it was like, two more broken world records, give or take. It was like women's team pursuit. Is it women's team pursuit? Yeah, women's team pursuit. It was like a new world record of 3 minutes 14 seconds and some other milliseconds. I was watching the quarterfinals and the that's quarterfinals, the semi-finals and the finals of the, I'll get my words out eventually, guys, but unfortunately an event like this requires concentration. There we go. What was it? I can't remember who was fighting. I know it was Australia and Canada, if I remember rightly. And obviously Australia got through. USA. And USA got through. I can't remember who Great Britain were against. Were we against Australia? I actually can't remember. But I know it was the finals of the team pursuit was Great Britain and USA. And after that, you know, after Great Britain's performance yesterday, you have to wonder, is actually anybody capable of beating Great Britain at cycling? Because that does seem to be our event. And we broke another world record. I can't remember how long it was. I think it was about like 3 minutes 13 some odd. I can't remember the exact record, but I know it was another broken world record. It's like we're setting world records and we're breaking them at the same time. It's just like our previous world records are like, nah, not fucking good enough. We gotta do it again. But all in all, it was a great day for Great Britain last night. 6 gold medals. And apparently that's like the most Great Britain has ever won in one day. For a long time, if ever. I hope that was a bullseye. So yeah, I haven't really been watching any Olympics today because I've been at work. and I've been back for about an hour and I haven't watched anything yet. So hopefully, fingers crossed, and we haven't broken any, records yet. So hopefully, fingers crossed, Great Britain can perform successfully again today. I'm not actually sure what events they'll probably be competing in today. I was going to watch the water polo again last night, but I thought to myself, yeah, Great Britain are probably going to bottle it, so I don't actually know what the result is of the Great Britain versus, I think it was Hungary last night. I don't know what the result for that was, so I'll probably find out in a second once I've done this video. And I'll be really surprised if Great Britain actually won. A new record! Can I get a whoop whoop? Oh, Tails is actually pretty handy with a gun, it seems. That's fucking scary. Oh, the London 2012 logo. £40,000 apparently that cost to make. I could have produced the same result by chucking 4 roofing tiles on the ground. Losers. I tell you what, Waluigi certainly is racking up their medals. Right guys, that's the end of today's events. Join me tomorrow where we've got a more ordinary day where we have women's uneven bars and Dream Equestrian. So until then guys, take care of yourselves and I'll see you tomorrow.